So Ivan, take us through the process of making a shoe right from scratch.
Okay, thank you. As you're going to start making a shoe, you have to make sure that you have leather with you. Mm-hmm. As you have leather, you also have a pattern. This is a pattern that can help you make a shoe.
So patterns come with different sizes?
Yeah, different sizes. This is size one now we are going to make. Mm-hmm. Just sample. We're going to make a shoe. So this is a design, or what I may call a pattern. Of course, when you're making a pattern, you have to make sure you have a pen. Not forgetting being accurate as you're doing your work. So this is a back strap. A back strap is like, this is a back strap, this one.
Okay, the one at the back.
That joins.
Different parts.
Yeah, different parts, yeah. So after designing it like this, you have to make sure that you have a scissor.
To cut out what you have designed.
Yes, right? To cut out what you have designed. Like in modernized countries, you don't need to use a scissor. That won't help you make 200 pairs a day if you're using a scissor. But you having a machine, mm-hmm. you just put what you have designed.
And it cuts it out.
It's yeah, press on it and it just cuts it. That helps you make 200 or 300 pairs a day.
So for now, how many pairs do you make a day?
Right now we just make just 50.
Because of the lack of machinery.
Yes, yes. But remember, our target is to make at least 150 pairs a day. That's our target. And I believe by 2020, we shall beat or we shall reach our target.
So how do you plan to beat the target? By getting more machines?
Yeah, we want to get more machines. We have already got in touch with some entrepreneurs in China, mm-hmm. others in Italy, but mostly we want to get in touch with those ones in Italy, because we all know that in Italy they are the best manufacturers of shoes.
Yeah, okay.
Yes. So after cutting it, I'm going to give it to my colleague Mike to skive. Skiving helps us to join these materials. Remember, these are leather materials. They are not plastic materials. If we are using like plastic materials, we wouldn't be skiving.
Skiving,
yes.
Is like smoothening. What other word would you use to
mean skiving? Smoothen. To make something, reduce on the size. You see us do this. Mike does skiving. Junior will be the other side on stitching.
Okay.
Yes. To simplify the work.
So each of you,
yes,
gets a specific, yes, role that you do in making.
Yes. Yes. Even as we have some other guys who do sewing.
So you don't skive the entire thing, you only skive the edges?
Where you want to join. Where you want to put on a stitching machine.
So you only skive the edges where you're going to add up to make the complete shoe. Like,
yeah.
Here.
Like here. Where you see like stitches,
yes.
Know that we skive.
That's
there.
The
here.
Skive.
Here. After skiving, we gum that side. After gumming it, we stitch it.
So what machine? What's the name of this machine that does the skiving?
This is called the skiving machine.
Do you find them here in Uganda? Can you get them like
no.
from Patwe, or are they
no.
imported?
These are imported machines.
And because of about how much?
This goes for, we bought it at 20M.
So if it weren't for the machine, you would be doing it manually?
Yeah.
Hard paper?
You see, like the way you may be having a knife, you get a knife, you keep cutting like this. Yes.
Ah, okay, so it would be more time. Like
yes, yes.
Okay. So after skiving the leather, what is the next step?
The next step, Junior is coming with gum. He's going to put on gum, put them on the stitching machine.
Okay.
Yes, Junior
so
is bringing
the gum before you stitch them.
Yes. Like the way you see right now, we are stitching.
That is after skiving.
Yes, that's after skiving. We are stitching now.
What is it that you stitch? You stitch the different parts together.
Yeah,
we
stitch different parts. Yeah, make a complete show. Right now it's putting on the back strap. So it's gumming it, putting some gum, some little gum, because if you put like a lot of gum, mm-hmm. you'll be affecting the like the needle there. It can't stitch it. She has put some a little gum. That's why she's
just putting, for it to be able to stitch.
Yes. As you can see, the shoe is already out now. Mm-hmm. The fashion is out. Now he's teaching what he has just gummed.
Okay.
Yes. To make the shoes so strong. Remember, we are not making these shoes just for the sake of doing business. We are doing something which is durable. That's why I try to put the gum where again is teach.
Okay.
Yes. So that lining is putting on creates confidence, creates comfort. When you're putting on a shoe, you feel like here.
So is this also leather, the lining that you use?
Yeah, it's leather. We don't use anything like plastic here. So right now it's joining the lining on the leather, which we have just got from skiving, from cutting and designing. Why do we put lining which is leather? We'd be using plastic, which is that is cheap.
Mm-hmm.
But we try our best to put something which is expensive. Why? We want to see that at least we beat out these competitors who import shoes. We have strategies. We want to see that at least by 2020, all going school children have a pay of a shoe here in the country. Yeah, from Rada shoes. How do you do it? When you make something fake, people can't come.
Yeah, sure.
When you make something durable, people always come here. So right now we have gummed. We give it some few, one minute to set.
Mm-hmm.
Then you again join on it. Because if you just join it without setting, without the gum setting, of course it has to come out. You put on a shoe, by the time you reach Chileka, you know, for us here, our children, they foot school. So by the time you know it, the kid will bring you the shoe that the shoe is already spoiled. Yeah, that's why we give it time.
But like I can see, not many of you wear hand gear. Doesn't this kind of usage of machines and affect your fingers?
Yeah, we'd be using hand gears, but why don't we use them? You know, most of the time here we use gums, we use gum most of the time here in everything we do. And you know it, if you're having like a gear in the hand,
it will stick to it.
So we used to use it, but find again remove, again put, so we got yours. But we try to take care as we're handling these machines. Yes. Okay, right now what we are doing is folding. Is folding, why do we do folding? Folding helps us to make the shoe bring out the real fashion of a shoe. If you don't fold a shoe, it won't bring out the fashion. So that's why it's folding to join the other lining on the leather. So is folding it to the upper design to come out very well. If I may show you now finished shoe, this is the folding I'm talking about.
This one at the top?
Yes, okay. This is the folding. As you can see, has already changed it. Like they were asking me, why is he stitching it from out here? It's already inside now. So after folding, you can see how the design has come out here on the top. As I told you, we try our best to put comfort in our shoe. You see, even put mattresses in shoes.
So you have to put sponge for it,
yes,
to be soft.
Yes. Again, stitch to join the lining in the side with the leather. And stitch the sponge inside.
Okay.
So that it so can't go out. Yes. Have you seen that?
Yeah.
Yes. Remember where we were skiving?
Yes.
That's why we are skiving now.
Reduce the thickness of the
leather. Yeah, the thickness. That's why we are skiving. if you are
those are points at which you're going to join it.
Yes. If you had not skived, it would be now too big. Okay. And it would be so difficult for junior to teach it. You can see that she's already here.